2020 has been a profoundly devastating year, and as is often the case, there were some lessons learned. For instance, I've learned fantasy football is not essential. Zoom meetings can be effective, and using DoorDash and other food delivery apps to support local restaurants is the way to go. But there have been more important lessons as well. As you know, adversity doesn't create character, it just reveals it. And over the last few months, we learned a lot about this community, including those who wear a St. Jude uniform. While the rest of the country was fixated on finger pointing, our physicians and caregivers stepped up, put their fears aside, and reacted to COVID with leadership, excellence, and sacrifice. And this community responded with generosity. And in the process, the character of both was made even more evident. During the early days of the pandemic, amid the confusion and chaos, our physicians and respiratory therapists were among the first to recognize the benefits of avoiding mechanical ventilation and developed labor-intensive but successful protocols to improve breathing without mechanical support. We were one of the first to use convalescent plasma to benefit patients and one of the first to create an effective method for sterilizing N95 masks, ensuring a steady supply of this critical PPE. While advancing outcomes for patients with COVID-19, our physicians and caregivers found ways to keep their families safe. Some rented apartments, others slept at the YMCA or hospital. Many volunteered for extra shifts to avoid contact with those they love. This community's response is one we will never forget. There were prayer rallies and parades through our parking lot. Local schools and organizations donated PPE. Restaurants donated meals, and families donated everything from disinfectant spray to homemade cookies. Seeing lines of cars in the front of the medical center, dropping off supplies and thank you notes, watching a catering truck arrive with dinner donated by a restaurant already struggling to survive, and seeing families parked outside the hospital praying and cheering. These were the scenes that often reduced our staff to tears and provided the encouragement and inspiration to begin another day. And we were humbled by the support of our community's first responders. There's another lesson to be learned from the last few months: the incredible importance of investing in your health. As media and public attention focused almost exclusively on COVID, other, maybe even more important health risks have been ignored. A recent study found a nearly 50% decrease in the diagnosis of common cancers since COVID began. A decrease that is not the result of a drop in the prevalence of breast, colon, or lung cancer, but a dramatic decline in diagnosis. As you know, delays matter when it comes to surviving cancer and many other conditions. It's time to start improving your health, not simply avoiding a virus. If you've been putting off a colonoscopy, a mammogram, or another health issue, don't. It's time. And if you've been putting off exercising because the gyms are closed, it's time to change that as well. There's no better time and place to be out walking, biking, or taking advantage of our amazing trails. The pandemic has hit us hard. And while there are things that we truly miss, the handshakes and the hugs, I'm hopeful that we will learn what really matters: a strong and vibrant community, our health and safety, being present with those we admire, those we love, and those who make us laugh. Thank you.